We present a fully automatic Blendshape generation method for stylized characters. Avatars are one of the most important elements in the virtual environment. In the industry, we often use a Blendshape to drive the avatar's facial expression. Each Blendshape represents a model single action unit of face with respect to the neutral face, such as left eye blink, jaw open, and etc. However, generating Blendshape for avatars requires a significant amount of the expertise and human labors. Okay, let's look at the detailed state of art of previous work and the highlights of our work. Our previous work have discussed the approach of the Blendshape generation. One classic method was proposed by Lee, which used the two-step automation method to obtain the Blendshape on an avatar. However, these methods require large datasets of animation with a labeled Blendshape weight, which is not easily to obtain. Alternatively, another approach utilizes the power of the deformation transfer. With the current well-defined fashion of Blendshape, such as 52 standard Blendshape provided by the ER kit for a human avatar, we can treat this Blendshape as a template and transfer the deformation from the template avatar to our target avatar. This approach offers more accessible solution compared to the previous method. The conventional deformation transfer approach involves transferring motion from vertex and surface based on the correspondence between the face from the source and the target models. However, establishing this correspondence requires manual labeling of the key points to register the model. They might be easy for the human faces, but very difficult for the stylized characters to obtain the key point. Some recent studies have demonstrated that deep learning models, such as VAEs, can efficiently and systematically transfer the deformation on one mesh to another. Our method is inspired by those VAE approach and use it to transfer the deformation of the Blendshape from a source avatar to target avatar. Additionally, we evaluate our methods by comparing it to the three baseline deformation transfer methods. Here, we discuss the detailed implementation about our methods. In our system, we begin by training variational autoencoder with various expression to create a continuous and a linear latent space for each avatar. Since the input and output of the VAE network are the same, we do not need to concern about labeling the dataset. After training the VAE, a crucial step is to establish a connection between two latent spaces of the source avatar and the target avatar. With this connection established, it becomes possible to generate a new realistic avatar by manipulating the latent space of the source avatar to match that of the target avatar. To establish the transformation from the source latent space to the target latent space, we train a multilayer perceptual models as a transfer function. The training datasets consist of a pair of the source and the target models with the same expression. This allows us to obtain the latent code of the certain expression of the source model by encoding through the VAE model. Then, we can use the MLP model to train the latent code of the target model. And finally, we can decode the target latent code to generate target avatar model with the same expression. The structure of the variational autoencoder and the multilayer perception model are shown here. Specifically, we talk about dataset construction. In our paper, we utilized a single avatar as a source for the Blendshape and test our system for 5 different characters. To train each variational autoencoder, we used 4,800 expressions, 418 of which we extract from public available dataset containing expression from various avatar, while the remainder was generated by some random variable to the facial controllers. Training each multilayer perceptual model required 900 pairs of the source-to-target facial expression animation. The creation of this source-target pair posed was a significant challenge for us. Therefore, we developed a strategy to automatically match these pairs. To accomplish this, we first obtained the emotion feature of each avatar by applying emotion recognition network. Then, We render the facial image and obtain the position of 49 facial key points. Next, we match the animation of the source avatar with that of the target avatar that exhibit a high degree of alignment in emotional feature and a low key point distance. This is the result for the avatar Mary. The Blendshape iBlink has some issue when obtained by the LDT method, such as the upper eyelid does not reach the lower eyelid, and the edge of the upper eyelid is not being smooth. Additionally, Blendshape obtained by Gauss and Zhang's method have a mouse deformation instead of the eyelid. However, our method does not have above issues, but the upper eyelid of the Blendshape obtained by our method sometimes not quite reach the lower eyelid. The Blendshape iSquid is a high quality applied through the LDT method, with no issue present. However, when obtaining the Gauss and Zhang's method, there was some deformation in irrelevant area. Our method resulted in the minimal deformation of the lower eyelid. The Blendshape gel-open obtained through the LDT method may result in corrupt deformation of the lips, while the method proposed by the Gauss may lead to asymmetry deformation and unexpected closure of the left eyes. Similarly, the method proposed by the Zhang also lead to asymmetric deformation. In contrast, our method has no issue to and produce a high-quality Blendshape that preserves the schematic and the symmetry. When it comes to the Blendshape, mouse right and mouse smell left, the LDT methods, Gauss method and Zhang's method all may lead to deformation in the irrelevant areas and the wrong schematics. In contrast, our method produces a Blendshape of high quality with preserved schematics and symmetry and has no issue. The Blendshape mouse poker poses a significant challenge for our method. Obtaining Blendshape for the mouse right has proven to be a difficult task for our baseline method. The LDT method may result in unfluent shape, while the method proposed by the Gauss and the Zhang's may lead to wrong schematic and corrupt deformation of the mouse. Each of these methods may achieve their own limitations and difficulty when it comes to generating accurate and realistic Blendshape for this particular expression. The results for another avatar are quite similar. This is the result for Ray. This is the result for Qing. And this is the result for Rose. This is the result for Marco. To quantitatively estimate the distance between our result and the ground truth created by our in-house artist, we calculate the mean square error between the result and the ground truth. Our methods achieve the lowest error score. We also conducted a user study to demonstrate the effectiveness of our method. In summary, to the best of our knowledge, we present the first fully automatic Blendshape generation method for stylized characters with a different topology. We particularly developed a pipeline to generate a reliable dataset of the pairwise facial rays. We demonstrate the Blendshape generated by our methods are accurate and of high quality, and its application to the source have a different style, such as have a different expression. We released a set of 52 standard Blendshape for 8 characters that sculpted by our in-house artist. These datasets motivate future study in the domain of the 3D animation. Thank you very much for listening.